What's the word, y'all? I know I, this is what y'all been waiting for, so I'm giving y'all what y'all been waiting for. It is the day after the NBA draft. As I'm recording this, it is 9 a.m., so I don't know if anything big is going to happen in the NBA today, but I'm just putting my time frame out there for reference. We're not talking about the entirety of the NBA draft. We're talking about the thing that you want me to talk about. As you know, I might be the biggest Bulls fan on YouTube. I'm the biggest public Bulls fan because some of y'all favorite creators are low-key Bulls fans, but don't just advertise it in every video like I do. I let you know every video that I'm a Bulls fan because I'm a diehard Bulls fan. It is tatted on my body. I don't want to spoil anything, but me and the Bulls are in works on some things. So I am a really big Bulls fan around here. And yesterday, they kind of surprised the world with drafting Patrick Williams, number 4. I was streaming on Twitch. Every single year, me and my guys on Twitch, my viewers over there, watch the lottery of the draft. It's been happening for, I think this is the 4th year in a row we've done this. And today last night, we hit some all-time numbers. Ended up having like 24,000 people watching me react to the Bulls pick Patrick Williams. So if you were one of those people, thank you for that. And if you weren't one of those people, I'll recap my emotions and everything in this video. Be sure to leave a like, subscribe if you're new. The NBA free agency is right around the corner. And I do want to talk about other things draft related, but those have to come in future videos. We're talking about the Bulls exclusively in today's video. So if you're not a Bulls fan, might not be for you, but maybe you just want to hear Kenny get upset, right? The Bulls picked Patrick Williams at 4. What the heck were they doing? And my overall emotion has been up and down since that pick. And if you go back and rewatch the Twitch stream, basically what I was saying when he was drafted was, okay, you liked him enough to pick him at 4, but he probably would have been on the board at 7 or 8. So in my mind, I thought like our front office should have been on the phones calling teams that are at 7 or 8. Maybe they want to trade up and we trade down. We still get our prospect and we get other things in return. Now, I'm glad I'm recording this video now and not recording it right after the draft because it came out that the Bulls were looking to trade down. They were looking to trade down to pick Patrick Williams a little bit later than that, but they couldn't find a team that was really interested in trading up to 4 because y'all know this was a top 3 draft in the eyes of everybody. We knew it was going to be LaMelo, Anthony Edwards, and James Wiseman. We just didn't know which order. We knew those were going to be the top 3 picks, and then number 4 was kind of a battlefield, right? It was Denny Abdee. It was Tyrese Haliburton. It was Killian Hayes. A lot of the mock drafts had different things at number 4. So nobody really wanted to trade up to number 4. So they knew, the Bulls knew that they really liked Patrick Williams. So they're like, okay, our fan base may see this as a stretch, but for us, it's not that much of a stretch. So we'll take him at 4. So, you know, we have Patrick Williams. And the funny thing is, I'm going to say this right here, and many of y'all know this if you've been around the channel for a long time. I am very far away from a draft expert. I will never come into this channel or anything in my life and say that I'm a draft expert unless I actually become that later, you know, I start to, you know, research a little bit more. So when I found out we had the 4th overall pick, I started to do my research on the players that were projected to go in that realm. So I did a lot of research on Denny Abdia. I did a lot of research on Tyrese Haliburton. I did a lot of research on Killian Hayes and some of the other guys, Isaac Okoro at number 4. Like, I did research on these guys because those were the guys that I was told through mock drafts were going to go at number 4. And none of them did, obviously. Patrick Williams, I look back the day after the NBA lottery, I went back to look at some of the old mock drafts. Patrick Williams was projected at that time to go around 11, right? But I guess over the last couple of weeks, his stock has been growing. It was rumored about a week ago that the Detroit Pistons were very interested. And that means he had climbed from number 11 to number 7. And then right before the draft, it was rumored that the Bulls liked him. And, you know, I don't think too much about rumors, especially around this time of the NBA season, because think about all the rumors that were dealt when it came to the NBA draft. It was rumored that the Timberwolves wanted to trade. It was rumored that the Warriors wanted to trade. It was rumored that the Bulls wanted to trade up. No trades happened in the lottery. And that's not from, I'm guessing that's not from the lack of effort, but nothing materialized. So when it comes to rumors, typically I'm a guy that's like, okay, let's wait for something to happen and then I'll react to it. So when I heard Patrick Williams that the Bulls fell in love with him, I didn't think too much about it until it was a done deal. So after they picked him, Ack, who is the guy that is in charge, I'm just going to call him Ack because Carney Chauvas is a mouthful to say, so I'm just going to keep calling him Ack. He did a post-interview where he basically talked about their thinking of Patrick Williams at number 4. And again, nothing in my draft stream that I say that Patrick Williams is a bad player, that he's a bust, because I still don't know much about him. I know surface level. He didn't start in college, but that's not saying much. We've had some great NBA players come into the league that weren't starters, but we do have players like Deion Waiters who didn't start at all and then end up being bad. So that doesn't mean anything to me right now. He averaged 9 points per game, but again, he was coming off the bench and he was playing for a team in Florida State that wasn't going to go out and average 100 points per game as a team. They were a defensive-oriented team on top of that. So he didn't start. He didn't average a lot of points, but there are bright things about him at the end of the day. This is the way I look at it. Everybody that could have gone at number four had holes in their game that needed to be developed out. And Patrick Williams is the exact same way. He apparently was a good playmaker in high school, is what was told to me. I don't know if I should be thinking about his high school film when he's in the NBA now, but all of this is saying, listen, once you put on this red jersey above me, I am a fan of you, and I am rooting for you until you show me otherwise. He was the youngest American-born player in this draft, which tells me that there's no reason for us Bulls fans to come out a week into the NBA season, and if he's averaging 3 points per game, to be overly dramatic about him. He was the youngest American-born player in the draft. He probably is going to be a project. I'm not projecting him to turn into Kawhi Leonard at all. I'm not projecting him to be anything amazing. At the end of the day, I want him to be a good player for us because at that wing spot, we have a lot of holes. Our two guys, Otto Porter Jr., as good as he is when he plays, he can't stay healthy. Chandler Hutchinson, we promised him with our last year pick, he can't stay healthy. Patrick Williams can come into the team right now and at least play rotational minutes. A team that needed some more defense on the wing position, we have that. We were playing Shaq Harrison and Chris Dunn as small forward a lot last year. We have a legit big-bodied small forward on the team. I know some of y'all clicked this video expecting me to overreact, to feel strongly one way or the other, but I don't. I'm dead set in the middle. We're going to have to wait and see how things go. We just are. We just are going to have to wait at the end of the day. Patrick, if you're watching this video, welcome to Chicago. My guy, if you need literally anything, hit me in the DMs. I'm going to be there. That's just the way it is. I'm excited that there is some buzz here in Chicago again. My guy who does my tattoo artist, compared it to the Bulls taking Trubisky. Not the Bulls. The Bears taking Trubisky. That kind of hurts. And I understand. Listen, this is what happens. And I saw somebody say this in my comment section on Twitter, and I 100% agree. The reason we see it as a stretch, it's because maybe it is, but also the reason why we might be thinking negatively about it is because we had fell in love with the players that were projected to go at four, right? I fell in love with Danny Abdia because he was projected to go at four, so I watched all of his film, I watched all of his highlights, I watched all of his interviews, and I fell in love with the player. We weren't projected to get Patrick Williams, so we didn't have the chance to fall in love with the player. Now, this is funny, though. Patrick Williams' draft stock was jumping to 7 or 8, right? And guess who fell in love with him? My fellow podcaster, my cousin, who was a Knicks fan. Once he was projected to go around 7 or 8, my Knicks fan cousin started to do his more research about him and fell in love with him. Now, if he was projected to go number four, and us Bulls fans would have had the time to dive into it as much as Ack in the front office did, maybe we'd love this pick. Maybe. I know surface level, there are people laughing at us Bulls fans because we reached on a guy that averaged 9 points per game in college and came off the bench. But at the end of the day, only time will tell. And time, well, it's starting. You know, camp is starting very soon. The games start, free agency starts, and preseason starts very soon. To give you a gist, I'm excited to have Patrick Williams in Chicago, and that is my only opinion at the moment. Let me know what you think in the comment section. I'll be back. Peace.